So this concludes the web programming track. We first took a look at how it is that computers and other devices are able to communicate with one another over the internet, using protocols like HTTP, TCP, and IP. Then we were able to create our first web pages, using HTML to describe the structure of a web page, all of the headings and the text and the lists and the images and the tables and more. Then, using a language called CSS, we were able to add style to our web pages, adding custom fonts and colors and sizes and other style properties as well. Using JavaScript, we could make our pages more interactive, writing code that manipulated the DOM, the document object model that described the structure of our web page, in order to add things to our web page, remove things from our web page, or manipulate that web page as the user interacts with it. Then, we built our very own web server, using a Python web framework called Flask that let us create a web application that generated dynamic HTML. And then we were able to connect that web application with a database to allow us to read and write data and create all the more interesting and powerful web applications in the process. And all of this are just the basic building blocks of how to build web applications. And there's so much more to explore. So if you're interested, look around for other HTML elements you could add to your page, other CSS properties you could use to style your page, other features of JavaScript and Flask that you can use in order to make your own web applications that are interesting and exciting to you. My name is Brian, and this is CS50.